3D printing could be the solution to building houses faster. Rich DeMuro explains it all in today's Tech Smart. Rich, good morning.
Hey there, good morning to you, Raul. Happy Monday to you. Yes, so many cities across America, especially many in California, facing an affordable housing crisis. And now technology might be able to come in and help ease some of the burden. One company I met with is putting high hopes on 3D printing houses as a solution.
It seems easy enough. Build new houses so people can move into them and enjoy life as a homeowner. Problem is, cities are hesitant to allow unlimited new construction. The workforce isn't there and materials are expensive.
But this is not something that we can overcome overnight. This is simple supply and demand.
Now, a Silicon Valley startup thinks they have an answer. 3D printing.
With our printers, we're able to print the entire shell of the structure or panels, depending which product we're talking about.
Mighty Buildings has come up with a special gel that cures instantly into a solid material when zapped with light. They've successfully 3D printed a 350 square foot studio apartment in 24 hours.
So this curved wall here is the 3D printed section.
This hybrid building is a combination of materials and starts at $115,000. The building functions as an ADU.
So an ADU is an accessory dwelling unit. It's the technical term for what are often called granny flats or backyard apartments.
Inside has everything you need, a bedroom slash living room, kitchen, and bathroom.
This is the 3D printed material that Mighty Buildings has developed for its units. You can see some of it exposed on the wall right here.
The material is about as strong and durable as concrete, but more energy efficient and easier to manage.
Because this would be really expensive to do in.
Exactly, with using traditional materials.
Yeah.
About 80% of this studio is created in a factory, then trucked to site.
What we're doing, we're introducing 3D printing to do some of the most dangerous parts of the job.
3D printing homes could be part of a blueprint to solve the housing crisis.
We have to change, and I do think that there's political will now to kind of review how we've done things in the past.
It's imperative that we embrace whole new ways of building to really unlock that productivity and that efficiency.
Okay, so you saw the studio where just that one wall was 3D printed, but the company says within a year they hope to 3D print the entire unit. If you want to learn more about what they're doing, go to my website. It is richontech.tv. Raul, we saw the studio, which, yep. You know, it's kind of like what you always dream of as a kid, living in like your own little tiny, you know, it's like a tiny house, but they can do all the way up to 3 bedrooms.
And the computer made it. That material's incredible. It's fast. When can people actually start buying it, though?
Well, you can put kind of deposits down now. It looks like they're delivering them next year, 2021. I'm sure things were a little bit pushed back because of the pandemic as well.
Yeah, that's unbelievable. Rich DeMuro, thank you, sir.